hybrid energy system. Is it feasible than compared to standalone system, solar system, or only the diesel energy system? So this just to compare. It's actually a very small study for me, my PhD. Very small topic about my PhD topic, but the details I didn't say. So these are the table of contents. Okay, this is a small background. So you can see that our renewable energy is contributing in our overall sector is only 2.93%. So mainly we are dependent on the natural gas. So particularly, like if we classify the renewable energy system separately, then we can see that solar is the main source for contribution. So we need to actually focus on renewable energy to balance our energy mix. So this is the situation about the off-grid electrification in our country, or standalone, whatever you say, same thing. So we can see that the solar home system, actually, which actually we use in like installing some rooftop solar or something like that. So in the villages or some island communities, so mainly they use this system. So you see the other things, the solar, these are very less actually. So we need to concentrate on the other types of combination of energy resources. So actually my focus in the research is based on the optimization system. So I use this kind of model. Like this model, this one, it's called HOMA. So you can see the hybrid optimization model for electric renewables. So this system can optimize the energy system or the energy parameters. But it cannot optimize some social index. It has a big limitation of this kind of optimization tools or software or any kind of method. So we need to integrate some kind of method with this kind of optimization system, which can overall consider the social parameters or maybe the policy issues or something like that. So these are some objectives. The objective is actually I try to integrate. Today I'm using MCDM method. I think some know about this multi-criteria decision making method. So I try to use this method. This determining the weights of the criteria, and this method actually use the for ranking. And this one, HOMA, which I told previously, it actually optimizes the system parameters, the quantitative parameters. It cannot deal with the qualitative tools. So I use this method, so that it can give some optimized results. So this is my decision model. So select the study area. So these some criteria I will select, and then actually the quantitative measures, which I will analyze with the optimization tools, and the quantitative measure I will analyze by the two experts in the system. And the weights will be calculated by which method I will use, and this will be the rank. And then if the rank is consistent, we take the final decision, and if it's not consistent, then we start from the before. So we have to do some sensitivity analysis to understand whether the rank is consistent or not. So these are the study areas. So actually, like you see this area, this is our country. So these green areas, these are actually the coastal areas of our country. And these areas are mostly isolated. You see this one. These are not connected to the grid. So you cannot have the electricity directly from the grid to these areas. So if we zoom out this one, so the situation is like this. So suppose this one, this area. This is one kind of off-grid area. So we can implement our system here to analyze that whether the hybrid system is optimized or not. This is the weighting method. Because one thing I didn't mention about this method, this one, because it requires a lot of calculation, estimation, so I didn't show this. The analysis of this platform. But I just showed the results. So this is the weighting method I use. And these are some criteria I use for analysis. It's a very little criteria. Because for a greater understanding, we need to consider a lot of criteria, maybe at least 24, 26 criteria. It's just a demo, so I just give very less. So this one, this criteria, this criteria. These are both the qualitative measures. So we will actually, that's the thing we improve the MCBM technique. Because these things cannot, you know, MCBM we can take the secondary data, but we cannot take the primary data. So we need to optimize this, this system through the optimization software, which I mentioned. And then integrate, also consider these tools. And overall, we analyze the system. And actually, this here we need to solve this. There will be some linear equation before calculating this test, and then we need to solve this one by any method, cross-sidal, iterative method, any method we can solve it, no problem. And then you can get the weights. Combination of these two methods, entropy and the Thanos method. So this is the most modified method compared to these two methods. So we can see that this one is wrong. This is wrong. This was like 23%.
Emissions,
yeah. That contains the highest weighted actually. So if we see the graph there, there's a graph. So entropy method will show that, you know, the weightage is too high, which is actually not feasible, not actually. But you, this method, the combination of these two methods, it shows a reasonable, not reasonable weightage. So you can consider by the graph we can see it's a reasonable weightage. So that's actually the advantage of this method, because it considers both two methods and gives an optimized results. And then this is the ranking method. After the ranking method, we got the decision. And this decision, you see, we got, my target objective was that whether this system is feasible or not, compared to these two systems. So the ranking method, there are two things here. One is PDF, one is NDA. Positive distance average and negative distance average. So this positive distance average, you see, it's covering almost all the criteria. So we can say that actually, this one could be the first rank or it's optimized. It is the first rank or the most feasible option. You can see from this result actually. And this is the negative distance average. So from here actually we can understand that you see the standalone result. That actually the value is negative almost all criteria. So we choose this as a negative. So because we actually choose three alternatives, so we can understand that the standalone sonar will be the second option. But this actually ranking method, if we consider the more alternatives, it will be more better results. So, yes. So finally we need to calculate the overall ranking, and then it will show that, you know, this hybrid system is actually more feasible than this score. So standalone can be compared to the compact as alternative option. And standalone diesel is actually not feasible, mainly due to the emission, because the weightage, higher weightage of the emission, and also the values of the emission. And then we just do some sensitivity analysis. We change the weights, because we consider some parameters, we change different weights. And we can see that even if you change the weight, the rank is okay. So we can just have a decision that it's okay. And then what I told, this lower cost of energy, less emission, and higher social benefits are the main reasons to choose this hybrid system. The same, on the other hand, this lower electricity production, higher investment cost, and cost of energy to lag behind the only diesel energy system. So we can say that actually the hybrid system should be more feasible in the off-grid area. And if we consider the second option, then we can consider this standalone solar energy system, which is actually off-grid solar energy system. We can consider it as a second option.